Hello and welcome to another edition of the Racing Post Postscript. I'm Sam Hansen and I'm joined by Racing Post senior writer Lee Mottershead at the end of what has been a marvellous day's racing at York on the second day of the 2019 Ebor Festival. And Lee, really, there's only one big talking point in Abel. She was spectacular, wasn't she?
Yeah, so there was heavy billing of this as hashtag Enable Day around the racecourse today. The sports marketing folk were really pushing that, and understandably so. And she delivered. I thought there was a palpable sense of trepidation beforehand, just in the sense that she was a long odds on favourite, but it could have been a tactical contest. It was very much a stepping stone towards the arc. And you never quite know what's going to happen. And we came here thinking this was almost certainly going to be a final race in Brin, which it almost certainly was. And we wanted her to do it. Yeah. And she did it. I thought, watching from the stands, there was a lovely moment about a furlong and a half out when from nowhere, some loud collective communal applause started ringing out around the place, as I think that relief just filled the place and the sense of anxiety disappeared, because it was obvious she was going to win. And ultimately, she's beaten Magical more easily than she did in the Eclipse at Sandown in July. She's won it well, and she set herself firmly now on course for Longchamp. And I thought, in some ways, the defining moments after the race came with Frankie Dettori and his reaction. He was emotional in an ITV interview, and then when we got a chance to speak to him after the race, he became emotional talking about having been emotional after the race. And listen, Frankie is an emotional guy. That's what we all know him for. He's a bullion. He's loud. He's in your face. He's jumping off horses. But you don't often see him emotional in the way he was here. He really has a very special bond with Enable. She means the world to him. And that was obvious today, and he spoke about knowing that this was almost certainly her British farewell, and that meant something to him. And geez, I've said in these conversations we've had before that this whole flat season has been building towards that first Sunday in October, and that's just increasing the case. It's going to be such a monumental day, and if you have been thinking about should I be booking a ticket to Paris, you really should. Because that could be one of the special days in our racing lives if she can go and make arc history.
Whether she can or can't is obviously at the moment speculative. We hope she can.
Yeah.
But 10 group ones and a fantastic run of winning, I think 14 wins on the bounce now, isn't it? Or 13. She has earned a place in racing history anyway, hasn't she?
She has. I mean, she hasn't yet reach that number, that rating, which puts among the all-time greats. But it's not a sport that's governed only by ratings. And I think what she's achieved in those 10 Group 1s, with her longevity, you know, she's racing into the autumn of her five-year-old campaign. You know, she's a wonderful horse. And what Carl Abdullah, her owner breeder, has done is she's allowed a racehorse to be a racehorse. He's let her race, he's let her be campaigned, he's let us enjoy her, primarily because he's enjoying her, he's enjoying seeing her race. She is one of the all-time greats, I think, in that sense. Certainly, I think in the hearts of people who watch racing, she's really become a very special race mare. And how marvellous that, you know, in 1 year, we've said goodbye to Winks in the Southern Hemisphere, and now we're preparing to say goodbye to Enable in the Northern Hemisphere. And just a wonderful time for fillies and mares in this sport. You know, we had a piece, I did a piece in the Post on Sunday about...
You know, lovely piece it was too.
You're very sweet, thank you. You know, we've had Zenyatta in the States, we've had to say Winks and Black's Caviar in the Southern Hemisphere, Enable over here. It's just a great time for these leading ladies of flat racing. And Enable continues to deliver, as I say, Oro's lead now to what is almost certainly goodbye day. If today was au revoir day in Brin, it's goodbye day in France on October 6th.
And actually, even the BHA's own Nick Russ was giving out Enable flags.
He was. He was. And I say this was all about Enable this day, and he was getting involved there as well. And it was great to see. But although it was all about Enable, there were some other good stories as well.
Yes, there was indeed. Mum's Tipple. very impressive. Very impressive.
It was remarkable.
Yeah.
You know, it was to see a horse gallop that far clear of a big field up York Straight Course. Well, I've never seen anything like that here in a race like that before. Astonishing performance, and he reached an astonishing figure on Racing Post ratings, 119, which is very, very rare to do in a non-pattern race.
Yes.
And I think Connections were they were surprised by the Man of the Port performance, but they clearly held the horse in high regard, and now they'll be looking at the Guineas next year and other major races. And yeah, it was a pretty remarkable thing to see.
It was truly remarkable from him, truly remarkable from Enable. It has been, as I said before, a fantastic day's racing here at York. We've got two more days to come, so don't forget to download the free Racing Post app for the must-have racing info.